Hello guys, in this video I'll show you the internal circuit of IC555 and I'll discuss each and every pins of IC555. So let's get started. Now before going to see the internal circuit of 555, let's see all the pins. Now pin number 1, 3 and 8 is very straightforward pins. Pin number 1 is connected to ground, 8 is connected to VCC and pin number 3 is the output. We can supply VCC from 4.5 volt to 15 volt. Okay. Now see the other pins. Pin number 2 is trigger pin, 4 is reset pin, pin number 5 is voltage control. Pin number 6 is threshold pin and the pin number 7 is discharge pin. I'll discuss each pin one by one with the internal circuit. In the first part of the circuit, we have 3 resistors in series. These 3 resistor value are the same. So we can call it R, R, R. And the value is 5 kilo ohms, 5 kilo ohms, 5 kilo ohms. So that is why this IC named as 555. We'll connect here VCC and in this end we'll connect ground. This end is pin number 8 and this one pin number 1. And here we have two nodes. Here one and here is one. Okay, we'll consider these two nodes. Now we have to calculate voltage in these two nodes. Okay, and we call this node as VTH and this node we call it VTL. So we have to find out the voltage in the VTH and in the VTL. We can write here VTH equal to, now we have to find out the voltage in the VTH node. Okay, so VTH equal to VCC multiplied by the total resistance from the node to the ground. So here it is R plus R, that is twice R, divided by total resistance in series, that is thrice R. RR get cancelled out, so 2 by 3 VCC. Okay, now VTL equal to VCC multiplied by total resistance from the node to the ground, that is only R here, so R, total resistance in series, that is thrice R. R and R get cancelled out, so it is 1 by 3 VCC or VCC by 3. Now we can write here 2 by 3 VCC, here it is VCC by 3, these two nodes. Okay, now after the series resistor, we have two comparators. Okay, this node is connected to inverting pin of comparator and this node is connected to non-inverting pin of comparator, and this pin is pin number 5, the voltage control pin, and this one is pin number 6, that is threshold pin. Okay, and this inverting pin is pin number 2 of IC. This one is trigger pin and this one is threshold pin. Now after the comparator, we have SR flip-flop. Okay, the reset pin is connected to first comparator and the set pin is connected to the second comparator, the output of the comparators. Here the output Q and Q bar. Q is the output of 555 IC, that is pin number 3, and Q bar is connected to one resistor and then it goes to base of a transistor. The emitter is connected to ground and the collector is the pin number 7, that is discharge pin. Okay, and the pin number 4 is connected to flip-flop and it is active low. So whenever we want to reset the flip-flop, we'll connect this pin to ground. And if this pin is not in use, then we'll connect this pin to plus VCC so that it gives low signal to the flip-flop. Now let's discuss the function. Let's you are applying 12 volt here, as here the voltage is twice the VCC by 3, so here will be 8 volt and here will be 4 volt. Okay, and here's the ground, so it is 0 volt. Now this 2 pin will control the output. As I have discussed in my comparator video, that if the non-inverting voltage is higher than the inverting pin voltage, then the output of the comparator is high. And if the inverting pin voltage is higher than the non-inverting pin voltage, then our output will be low or zero. Now, if we are applying more than 8 volt to the pin number 6, then our output will be high. And if the output is high, then the reset pin of flip-flop will get high signal. Now let's see the inputs and output of flip-flop. This is the inputs and output of SR flip-flop. Whenever both the input gets 0, 0, then there will be no change in the output. And if S is low and R is high, then Q is 0, Q bar is 1. And if S is high and R is low, then our output, that is Q, is high and Q bar is 0. And both the input is 1 means it is not possible or undetermined output. Okay, now see this. If you are applying in the pin number 6 more than 8 volt, then the reset pin of flip-flop will get high. Then our output will be low. Okay, and if you are applying less than 4 volt in pin number 2, then its output will be high, as pin will receive a high signal. Then this Q will be 1 and Q bar will be 0. As a result, pin number 3 of the IC will get a high signal. That is, our output will be turned on. And we will see about pin number 7 in the monostable and stable mode of the IC. At that time, we will discuss all this thing, because we have to add one capacitor externally so that we can make a function of pin number 7. So in this video, I'm not going to add any external device. So I'm not going to discuss about pin number 7 in this video. I'll talk about this in monostable and astable mode of IC555. In the next video, I'll explain that. And as we know, the pin number 5 is voltage control. That means we can supply any reference voltage to this inverting pin. This pin is by default, it is twice the VCC by 3. But if you want to apply some other voltage, then you have to supply the reference voltage to this pin. Or if you are not using the pin number 5, then just connect this pin to the ground through a 0.01 microfarad capacitor. We can use this IC to generate beeping sound or tone generation, PWM signal generation, or for the timing delay circuit. Okay, so these are the three basic applications of IC555. So guys, this is all for today. I hope you like this video. If so, then please like, share and subscribe to my channel. And if you have any doubt on this, then please let me know in the comment section. In the next video, I'll show you the astable mode of IC555. Till then, stay happy and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.